I think is about myth busting. It's about leveling the playing field, recognizing that people with mixed abilities still have wants and desires and desire to have fun, and get together does that in a huge range of ways, whether that's in speed dating, in panto, in boozy nights out. It gives its members a real chance to have to lead a normal adult life, and I think that there's nothing more important than that.
Good relationships are what give us a sense of self and make us all feel respected and liked and needed.
That it's always the dawn of an approach to adults who live with disabilities to say you can lead a truly adult life. Not only you can, but you should, and you should demand it.
We let everybody learn the skills of self-determination through doing things, to experience through making mistakes, through trial and error. When you're working with somebody, our natural instinct is to want to help them succeed. We want them to do well. We want them to have nice experiences. So that can sometimes cause us to step in and do too much. So that actually the person always does succeed. And this means that actually maybe the person doesn't have the opportunity to then build resilience through failing, the normal part of life. But also it means that the individual doesn't have the opportunity to learn problem solving or thinking what person now try that.
So sometimes it's just realising if you just try something, you never know what a change it could make, and it's just like get together. Where would I be without get together? I would probably still be mollycoddled by my family, who in their way thought they were helping, but they didn't give me the chance to do these things myself.
At other times in the past, people have tried to stop me from taking opportunities. The first time I applied for the Ambassador role, I didn't get it. And I remember saying to family and friends, they thought I was stupid or mad. Era as a climate for a second time. But I thought, well, sometimes you have to keep going in order to succeed.
And I think when we talk about self-determination, it's quite easy because we've all spoke about our role to be employed. That isn't the only way you can be self-determined. Whatever anybody wants to do, as long as it's their voice that's being heard and they're the ones driving forward, that's self-determination. Mm-hmm. Whether it be getting a job, getting married, having sex, you know, having children, whatever it is, going to a nightclub, deciding when you want to go home,